Good day to everyone out there. I have a burden to share with us from the Word of God. I want to talk about the love of Jesus. We are going to read from John 3:16. The Bible says, "For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." Everyone out there wants to be loved and needs someone to love him or her. Now, the Bible says, God so loved the world, which means love originated from God. He loved the world and he made a giant step. He made a very significant step by giving his Son. We were all condemned to death because of the sins we had committed. The Bible says, God asked who will go and set mankind free. And he spoke to the angels, they refused. And his Son accepted to go to come and die for mankind. God loved us. He made a significant step by giving his Son to die on the cross of Calvary. He died that we should be set free. He died that we should have liberty to serve him. For us to accept this love, and a sign for us to show that we have accepted this love, because God has presented this love to us, is by us giving our life to Christ, accepting him as our personal Lord and Savior, giving him the charge to reign over our lives. Today, I'm calling upon you, brother and sister, mother and father, that have not made this Jesus your personal Lord and Savior, that you should accept his love that he presented to you. He has presented to you out there in all forms. We sleep every day. We get up in the morning. We don't know what happened all through the night. The Bible says Jesus, he does not sleep nor slumber when it comes to watching over his children. We are saved. We are preserved. We can see a new day. It's not by our effort. It's because of the love of God. Today you have an opportunity to make it up to make it the kind of giant step God did by giving. He taught us how to give by you also giving your life to him, making him your Lord and Savior. The beginning and the end of your life, the one you look up to, the one you depend on for everything you need. I know you have been living without accepting this love, but today Jesus's hands are open. He's waiting for you to come to him, to accept this love, to walk with him, so that things will no longer be the same in your life. You must have been making it while you have not accepted the love of Jesus. But it doesn't mean all is well. He's still waiting for you to come and accept his love. He's still waiting for you to come and surrender your life to him. The Bible says he loved us. He gave his only begotten Son of God. His only begotten Son. What a sacrifice that he did. What he needs from you is not you sacrificing a human being to him. He just needs you to accept him as your personal Lord and Savior. Accept him and go his way. Accept him and do as the word of God. That is our manual, the manual of the children of God. Go the way the manual is telling you. Dance to the tune. Serve him. Give him a place in your life, so that he can reign. And you will enjoy life, I bet you. Year and year after, you will enjoy life the best. And your life will be a blessing to many out there. I just wish to say, if you have not accepted the love of God, and you are ready to accept now, can you join with me? Can you repeat after me as we pray? You say, Lord Jesus, thank you for my life. Thank you for the grace you have given to me, and you have kept me all this while. Today I come to you I surrender my life to you. I accept you as my personal Lord and Savior. And I pray, may you take charge over my life. In the name of Jesus. I want to pray for you, dear. My God and my Father, I appreciate you for the life of my brother, my sister, my auntie, my uncle, my father, my mother out there. I pray as I've made this confession on today, may they have a new life in you. And may you take charge over them. And may you fight for them. May you protect them. May you promote them. May you bless them. Thank you, Abba Father, for it is well in the name of Jesus. I want to pray for you out there that you know that you are sick. Whatever you are sick, can you lay your hands there? The best miracle so far that can happen on this planet Earth is when people give their life to Christ. And when people have accepted Jesus, every other miracle can easily take place. So I want to pray for you that are sick out there. The Bible says sickness is not our portion. Our birthright is divine health as children of God. So I'm praying for you, Father, in the name of Jesus. Whatsoever my brother, my sister, my auntie, my uncle, my mother is sick out there, I declare, let there be healing in the name of Jesus. I assess the heavens for divine healing and divine intervention upon that situation, upon that hand, upon that waist, upon that body, upon that deadly situation. And I speak life unto it. And I say, let it be done in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Jesus, for it is well and it is done according to your will. In the name of Jesus. Amen.